Nemo Radio is on the air.
A, B, C. A, always, B, B, C, closing. Always be closing. Always be closing.
Shirley, you can't be serious.
I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
Put that coffee down.
Coffee's for closers only.
Come after me! I'm a man! I'm 40!
Hey, it's John Nemo. Welcome back to another episode of Nemo Radio. I just did something fun. It's so interesting when you're in business, and it's easy to kind of, you know, what is the definition? They say the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. So instead of just going insane again, I thought I'm going to try something different. And I don't know how this will work. So it was a real-time experiment. But here's an example of kind of doing something differently. Here's the scenario. So I sent out an email basically that says, hey, are you interested in, you know, creating a more client-attracting LinkedIn profile? If so, maybe we should talk. I have a whole team now that helps me, you know, with a done-for-you LinkedIn profile rewrite. And there's a whole big process involved. And if you're interested, you know, here's a video that walks through the process plus a form you can fill out that kind of says, you know, hey, here's my situation. Here's what I'm looking to do, blah, 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 blah. And then we like can kind of take it from there and say, oh, yeah, you'd be a good fit for the done-for-you profile rewrite. Let's talk live. Or, oh, based on what you're telling me, actually, this template might work better, et cetera. So anyway, I sent that out and somebody wrote back, and this happens every time I send an email. They just wrote back, price. How much is it? Like, what's the price? Question mark. Now, what I used to do is I would just write back with the ballpark price and say, oh, the ballpark is X, right? And 99.999 times out of 100, the person would say, oh, too expensive, out of here, right? And so instead, I stopped, because that's what I normally do. Or the other thing I would normally do is I would just say, well, this is the ballpark price, and here's why it costs this much. And I would write out a big, long thing. And again, it kind of, and I would just say, I wouldn't really end with asking what the person wants to do. I would just say, this is what it costs, you know? So here's what I did instead. I pulled out this set of flashcards. So flashcards? What is this, the 80s? Yes, I live in the 80s. Okay. So there's a sales trainer I really like named Josh Braun, and he's got this set of just goofball flashcards. It's called Tongue Tied, and it's these just little, like, you know, index size cards with all the most common sales objections you often run into, right? And so, and then his on the front end is the common objection. And then on the back end is how he coaches you to respond to it. And it's meant for like a sales call or a cold call, but I'm like, I'm going to use it for this email. So I found my little flashcard from Josh that says, you know, the common objection is what's the price? And that's exactly what they wrote in the email. And then on the back, he suggests that you start by diffusing the objection, right? So starts with, well, it depends, right? Like, it depends. The price depends, especially for this because it's a done-for-you kind of content, you know? And then he basically will, like, in his card, he'll basically make a joke and be like, hey, it's typically this ballpark range. I take Visa or American Express. Can you see yourself falling in that range? Like, I kid, right? Like, haha. Like, he's like, if you need to proactively bring it up, do it that way. Like, make a joke of it. Like, well, this is the ballpark range. Can you see yourself falling into that? If so, here's my, you know, I'll take Visa, you know, like, haha. But then the other thing is, like, so diffuse it and then discuss it, right? And so the copy he has for, like, that you can use on the sales calls, like, hey, I'm about to ask you a direct question. I don't want to do you a disservice, which I love because you're saying to the client, I don't want to do you a disservice. I don't want to waste your time. So literally he has, like, I don't want to do you, prospect, a disservice by wasting your time, you know, insert the blank, doing a demo, talking more, blah, 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 having you watch a video. Only for us to realize, though, although we like each other, we can't be best friends because we're too expensive. So based on what you told me so far, would it be okay, again, asking permission, if I ran some numbers by you? It's between X and Y. How does that feel? And so in this case, of course, I'm not on a live call, so all this doesn't apply. But basically for the email, I kind of just did a hybrid of it. And I said, hey, Joe, I'll just say that's the name of the person. I said, what's the price? And I said, the short answer is it depends, right? And then let me read what I actually wrote, and I can critique myself in real time with you here. So I said, the short answer is it depends. And I said, I don't want to do you a disservice if price is the main factor, right, for your buying decision. Because again, remember this for sales, you never want to compete on price. if you're going to, you know, whoever has the lowest price, you're just racing to go broke the fastest. You're racing to get to free. You're racing to get to zero. You never want to be like, oh, we're the cheapest. We're the cheapest. Or I'll lower my price. I'll match. Like, you want to have such value and credibility with your brand that you're not the cheapest. And in fact, in my case for Done For You LinkedIn services, I would think, I haven't checked, but just what I know, I would think our agency is far and away the most expensive. Far and away. Like, you know, and I want us to be that. I want us to be the Tesla, BMW, Apple, you know, Google of our industry. Like, I want people to be like, oh, they're the most expensive for a reason, right? So that's the brand I'm building. So anyway, I say, the short answer is it depends. I don't want to, this is the email I wrote back to this person. I don't want to do you a disservice if price is the main factor and if you're comparing us to other services and price is the main decision point. So I kind of repeated myself there, but that's okay. I said, and then I just bring up the elephant in the room and I say, this is the email. I say, we are likely far and away the most expensive option you'll find. And then I say, and that's because everything we do is hyper-customized, which is true. Like our process for rewriting your LinkedIn profile, we literally interview you for an hour. I bring my whole agency. So when I say this in the email, everything we do is hyper custom and I bring in a full marketing agency team, which is anywhere from 4 to 8 people, copywriter, project manager, graphic designer, marketing strategist, copy editor, senior content editor, and there's actually more involved to handle the process. Because my whole thing is like, we bring in our full agency even for your profile rewrite. Because what I have found that works on LinkedIn is we have to capture the real life you. So we do an hour-long Zoom call. Like prior to rewriting your profile, we onboard you, we get links to all your content, information, website. We digest it all as a team internally. We meet about it all. We riff about it. We talk about it so that when we get to your kickoff call with the full agency, we've already studied and learned everything we can about your online brand and what you've told us in your onboarding form. And then we dig even deeper with a one-on-one call for an hour, which, by the way, we transcribe, we save the video, and we look back at it and go, okay, how did Sally explain X? And how, in Sally's words, how would she address this? Because then that's the copy and the content we use for your profile is your real words, your real voice, your real personality. So again, all of this to say, hyper, hyper, hyper customized, right? And my graphic designer does stuff for Martha Stewart and pro football teams and like best in the business, right? So yeah, we're not like, you know, someone you find on Upwork or Fiverr, right? Like we're the opposite of that brand. And so I said, I wrote all that basically in one sentence and then said, with that said, the ballpark range is usually X to Y. And I won't say the actual range now because you might listen a year from now and be like, well, you said you'd do a profile for this and the price could be totally different. Like I literally had that happen where when I first launched coaching, I launched it at one price point. And 2 years later, somebody listened to that podcast and was like, I want to do your program for X dollars. I'm like, oh, it's now actually Y dollars. And they're like, well, no, your podcast said, I'm like, that podcast is from like 3 years ago, dude. Like things have changed. So that's why I won't say the price here. But I said, the ballpark range is usually X to Y for this profile rewrite. How does that feel to you? Right? How does that feel to you? And it looks like the person already wrote back in real time. So that probably means they're like, go jump in a lake. Yeah, he wrote back, LOL. And he said he wants to do it for $50. I'm like, yeah, okay. Understandable. So, like, again, I save my time by a lot of times people be like, well, let's just get on a call. Let's get on a call, right? And it's like the reality is, in my experience with sales, like, if someone and here's what I'll do in real time. I'll send him my free stuff and be like, hey, if it still helps, here's my free profile template. If it helps, so I'll actually pause the podcast and send this to him. So I just wrote him back a quick email that said, haha, thanks, right? $50. Like he's asked you price shopping, fine. But I mean, that way, think about all the time I would have wasted if I had a scarcity mindset and if I was so desperate to try to make any sale that I said, oh, let's get on a call. Let's get on a call. You know, the price will range. Let's just get on a call. And if no matter, I could put all this effort into a call and all this time and blood, sweat, and tears. And then he could simply say to me, oh, this is all sounds great, but I only want to spend $50. And it's like, oh man, like I didn't listen, right? I thought I could somehow magically talk you into it. Whereas with my email, again, you're trying to find the right person. You know, if someone says, I want a new car, you know, and your Tesla or BMW, you're, you know, how much is your new Tesla model? It's like, well, if you, I wanted to write back to this guy, like, if you have to ask, right? Like, you know, you can't afford it. Like, that's probably what luxury brands do. Like, how much is your new Ferrari? Well, if you have to ask, right? And you'll see that oftentimes they don't even have prices on their website for these luxury items, because again, they're not courting the people that are going to buy a Hyundai or a used Toyota. So like, really understand your brand and like who you're going for. And so if I get someone where their first immediate question to me isn't related to like, how can, you know, can you do this with my profile? Can you do that? Blah, blah, blah. It's just how much. That's usually a red flag to me of, okay, let's like, instead of getting on the phone and trying to work my magic, like they probably don't have any money, or they have a scarcity mindset, or they're just price shopping, tire kicking. You don't want to waste time with that. So now this, I took the time to write back this person and basically can have a template for future people that say, how much? Hey, here's the explanation. Here's why the price range is what it is. Here's why it's so expensive, because we do all this extra stuff. That may not be for you. You may not need that, right? Same with our Done For You LinkedIn lead generation. Like, it's not for people that are selling a $10 product or a $100 product. It's people selling services that, you know, one new client is $5,000, $10,000, $15,000, $25,000, $30,000, like, right? It's higher ticket stuff. So just be confident in that. Have a growth mindset, or what's the opposite of scarcity? Just have an abundance mindset. That's what it is. Like, I don't have to like haggle with that person from my current profile rewrite price down to $50, right? And by the way, every time I've done that, every time I've haggled on price and gone below what I feel comfortable charging, those clients have been the absolute god-awful worst human clients in history. They've been the most needy. They've questioned everything. They've been drama, divas, asked for refunds, chargebacks, because they're bad clients, because they're coming in and it's everything's about the price, right? All, I mean, you know this in your own experience, like, the lowest paying clients, the ones that haggle you and nickel and dime you all the way to below what you're comfortable with your rates, they're the worst clients. Who are the best clients I've ever had? The highest paying. Why? Because they're about results. They're about get it done. They're about, if I'm paying this, go do your job. I'm not going to sit here and babysit you. I'm not going to sit here and second guess you. I just want the results. Go, right? And those are the clients we have the most success with. Right? The low paying clients, maybe it's they come in scared and like, this is a ton of money for me. And, you know, I got to get every nickel out of this. So I'm going to just go outside the scope and ask a million questions and second guess and explain this and explain that and show this and show that. Whereas the high paying clients are like, I don't care how you do it. Just give me leads. I really don't care. Like, here's the money, go do it. You know, that's the best client ever, right? So it's just a good lesson overall. And I wanted to share this just kind of as it came up in real time, because I think, you know, the core thing I started with on this podcast was insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result. So try a different thing. Like, you know, and even just the specific example of, if people start with what's the price, have an answer for that and have an explanation for that, where you can kind of say, you know, well, it sounds like price is a concern. Can you tell me more about that? And they can say, yeah, I only have $10 to my name, you know, but so, you know, whatever. Or sounds like price is a concern. Can you tell me more about that? It, you know, is this something where price is going to really be the deciding issue for you? Like, are you looking at multiple services and really it's just whoever has the price tag? Yes. Oh, okay. Well, then you're not a good fit for us. See you later. Like, that way you just, again, you have to have that abundance mindset of, there are so many good leads. There are so many people that are willing to pay you what you're worth and not haggle you and nickel you and dime you. And by the way, they'll be your best clients ever. As opposed to, if you have a scarcity mindset of, oh my God, I can't turn away anyone who shows a pulse and asks about my product, I'll drop all my prices and do everything, you'll just create nightmares for you and for your team. Like, I have learned that. I have apologized to my team over the years. Like, they're like, this client's killing us. And I'm like, and they were the one that haggled me down below what I wanted to charge. You know, and sure enough, it's like, you know, I just was in a bad mindset that day of like, oh, I just got to make the sale, you know, as opposed to like, here's the other thing too that I've learned is like, whoever is willing to walk away has the leverage, right? So if you come across as desperate and I'll do whatever it takes to close the deal today, including slashing prices and doing all this stuff, the buyer has all the leverage. As opposed to, like, you don't get to go into a Ferrari dealership and be like, yeah, I see that's 100K for a new one. How about 80? Let's haggle a little bit. Do you think a Ferrari dealer is going to haggle with you? Like, no way. Like, at least I wouldn't think so. Whereas if I go into Hyundai and they're like, this, you know, this used Hyundai is $13,200. I'm going to be like, all right, I'll give you two. You know, I can start the banter and do the used car sales bit because they're competing on price, right? Low ticket, low price car, they got to move a bunch of inventory. Ferrari, they don't need to sell a Ferrari every day to be successful, right? And so they're waiting for the high value prospect to come in and goes, yeah, I want the red one. Or does it come in blue? Price ain't the issue. Can it do this and this? Can it go 200 miles an hour? Whatever. Think about your business that way. It's scary. It's scary when you don't have the revenue at the moment. And it's scary if you're struggling or in a down slope or a down season with sales. But that's really the mindset challenge, to stay in that abundance mindset. And what I say to myself is, there's nine, I use LinkedIn every day for lead generation, obviously, for me and for my clients. There are 900 million people on that platform. You know, and I don't need all of them to buy my stuff. Like, if I can find nine, like, I'm good, right? So stay confident, stay in that abundance mindset, and don't cheapen yourself. Don't give away your value just because you're desperate to make a sale. You know, I think that's the key thing with pricing. So anyway, hope that was helpful. It was good for me to process it out loud. So anyway, who knows? You can turn an email into a podcast episode. There you go. Thanks so much for listening, and we'll see you soon on another episode.